I'm living in that 21st century. Doing
yo, how's it going? It's Kieran. Hello, hi, hello. And today we're talking about humour and how it relates to picking up them chicks. I've had a shitty day today, by the way, and you know what? I was really excited to come and chat to you lot. How fucking sad is that? But I was. It's like, it's making me happy coming and chatting to you lot. So anyway, let's talk about fucking humour. What type of... We all know what humour is, of course. Comedy! What type of humour is attractive to girls? What do they like? Is it the quiet sort of David Mitchell, who, if you're American, he's sort of a British comedian who's sort of down on himself? Is it that kind of humour where it's everything self-deprecating? Or is it the loud and brash, like... Kind of the loud and brash is more the way we want to go to attract girls, and even though that sounds obnoxious. But let's get into it a little bit more. Yeah, you might have heard the term cocky funny before. Cocky funny. If you're in the community, you'll have heard of it. But yeah, that's basically what you are trying to do. You're engaging a girl with humour that shows off your personality, and hopefully you can be showing off a personality that is bubbly and cool and light and happy. And humour can be dark, obviously, as well. And you can have a dark personality and you can attract girls with a dark personality. But personally, I think it's better to not have a dark personality if possible. And I think the world's dark enough and we could have a bit more lightness. Obviously, people go through dark times, but that's another thing. So cocky funny, you want to be, I mean, part of this is the humour that girls find attractive. So this is two parts of this video. Part of this is the humour that girls find attractive. And the other part of it is, you do you, player. You do what you find funny, and kind of your frame will carry it through, and it will kind of just... If you do it right, the girl will laugh along with you, right? So yeah, some examples. I mean, this is just great humour that I've heard other people do, and I'll credit them. And it's just, these are just great examples that you can go out and use today, right? So one is from a guy called Todd Valentine, who you might have heard of, maybe not. This is a great line. So he'll go up to a girl just basically off the opener. So maybe he'll say, hi, how are you? Oh yeah, I just noticed something about you. And he says, do you know what I really like about you? And she goes, what? He goes, nothing. Like, I just think it's pretty good. And it's like, if you deliver that like correctly, and then just like smile with it, I think it's a pretty killer line, right? That sort of thing is really good. Another great example, this one's from a guy called Jeffrey Allen, who is into this stuff as well. And he sort of says, he's like going up to a girl and like maybe see her in the club. And it's like a situation where you could speak a little bit more, not dirty, but a little bit more sexually than maybe you could in the street or in the school or whatever, right? So you go up to girl and he's like, you know what I want to do to you, girl? You know what I want to do to you? He's like, I want to get to know you like over a couple of months, like take you out slowly at your own pace so you never feel pressured. Maybe on the second date to get to holding your hand and kissing you on the lips, maybe. Take you back in my car and drop you off at home, and then over the next couple of weeks and months get to know your peer group and be introduced to them and make a good impression on everyone and slowly date you at a speed that you're comfortable with and eventually marry you and have beautiful kids with you and grow old together dying in each other's arms like that. And it's just like it's insane, right? I mean, it's like it'd be difficult if you're a newbie guy, and I honestly, he does it a lot better than I just did it there, right? But it's like, if you're a newbie guy, that's difficult to go out and newbie. Look, I'm saying the lingo, I can't help it. I'm talking about this game stuff, the lingo just comes out. Remember at the start of this channel, I was like, I'm gonna be all different. Yeah, PUA, I'm gonna make it different. And I'm using all the lingo. Anyway, newbie means new, someone who's not good at getting with girls at the start, right? If you're like that, it's difficult to go up and do this like this long spiel to a girl, like, you know what I'm going to do to you, girl? Like, you probably wouldn't even get as far as that. It's difficult, right? So maybe that's a little bit, takes a little bit more practice. Or maybe by the end of a great night, you could try something like that and it'd probably go off great, right? Yeah, I just think it's really funny because like, if you think about it, like, think about lines that girls have heard all the time, like the classic line that a girl has heard, like, if she is a beautiful girl, she's heard, "Hey, beautiful," or "I think you're beautiful," or some variation of beautiful, like, maybe 10,000 times, literally, certainly in the thousands of times, right? So it's just, if that's all you're coming with, that's nothing. That's just pooed away, like, instantly, right? Let's not get it twisted. Like, the 6'5" jock with the girls all around him and the money and the status and the looks and the blah, 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 and the Ferrari, he can get away with shit lines like that, right? But we're talking about regular guys like us, right? Just normal people, right? They've heard that beautiful shit that a million times. But if you go up and you say that story about, "I want to get to know you, girl," like, just from if you don't, like, you're really someone who doesn't get humor. The reason why it works is a funny thing, is because you're inverting what she's expecting. "You know what I want to do to you, girl? It sounds like dirty," right? And you invert it with this really wholesome thing. And if you said that to a girl, she'll have heard that zero times before. And that's what's a big concept in game, is being different, showing yourself to be completely different to other people, right? Standing out from the crowd. So that's an example of why that sort of thing works. And there's a lesson, right? You can take something that's, she's gonna expect you to say something a certain way, and if you invert it, and especially if you invert it in a wholesome way, that's generally gonna be thought of as kind of very funny, right, from the girl. So that's that. So the other side of things we were talking about, doing things that you find funny, right? I mean, I remember being on this holiday once when we were younger lads, and going up with my mates, and we just found it hilarious to start a story in the middle of a story to a girl, right? So you go up to her and you're just like, "Hey, hey, hey," and she turns around and you're like, "Hey, hey." And he's like, what, you know, so he was jumping up and down, and then the car came, and then it's just stupid, right? He's like, and then the car came, and then he's like, and then he jumped over the car, and then they came out, the paramedics, they were running out. Me and my buddy Raj were saying this, and we were laughing so much, like, couldn't get it out, we were laughing. I know it doesn't sound funny at all, obviously, right now, right? But we found it so funny at the time, we couldn't get it out, right? And you kind of think, because you're probably a logical guy, right? And you're just thinking, like, if someone came up to me and started talking that gibberish, I would fuck them off immediately. It's like, imagine if you're a very polite, like, logical man, you're going to be like, "Excuse me, sir, like, what are you talking about? Like, what does that mean? What is the story? Like, start at the beginning and then get to the end, or don't tell me at all." It's like, girls aren't like that, right? It's not like they're completely different, but they're more in tune with emotions than we are, right? And they're less in tune with logic than we are, right? There's an overlap, but they're more into the emotions, we're more into the logic, right? And so they're basically, they're experiencing you when you come up and do that. They're not like, "What was the detail about the logical detail in the story?" They don't really give a shit about that. They're like, "Oh, what's this guy coming up who's got the confidence to, what's his story?" And he's laughing, like, they're going in on that feeling and that, like, that new experience of the club, right? Do you see the difference? You can do stuff like that. Like, when you're at pre-drinks, say, with your mates before you go out in a club, like, this is a normal thing we do. I don't know what you call it in America. We call it over here, like, sessioning or pre-drinks or pre-lash. That's when you have some drinks with your mates before you hit the club or before you hit the bar, right? I mean, if you don't have mates, like, maybe you can work on that before getting the girl, and I can show you how to do that as well, right? Whatever you and your guys are finding funny, you can fucking just do that with girls, and the state of you finding it funny will probably transfer onto them, right? And if it doesn't, you'll be having so much fun anyway, like, you won't care. And trust me, like, maybe a couple will be like, "What?" It will hook some girls for certain, right? And yeah, and that brings us on to another point. It's like game. It's like the same person who said that long story. He sometimes says, like, it's called the game. It's not called the work. It's supposed to be fun. It's supposed to be enjoyable. For you to if you're shit at this right now and you want to get good, for you to get good, you're gonna have to kind of enjoy it, right? I mean, you could just slog it out hating it, but probably it's just much better for you and your growth if you enjoy what you're doing, right? And adding some fun, adding what you personally find funny into interactions is gonna make you enjoy going out and learning this stuff and improving it, this stuff, right? Another one, obviously, laughter is infectious. Same sort of concept, right? It's like, yeah, you're laughing and she's just laughing. Like, and girls are like really funny for this. Like, if you, let's say if you come into an interaction, you're like laughing, you can, they'll just start laughing and you'll be like, well, you can even ask them, like, why are you laughing? They won't know, but they are, right? They're laughing with you. Another big thing, so tongue in cheek, right? I like, when I was a single lad, I like really, like, bold things to say. I like saying bold things, right, to girls, like whatever, like we can maybe that's another video, but just like you can say what you say, like say bold things. Like if you've heard of the comedian Patrice O'Neill, you know what I'm talking about. If you've not heard of him, check Patrice O'Neill out. This guy's a god when it comes to picking up girls and just philosophy behind this stuff, right? He's a comedian in the United States. If you know Bill Burr, another US comic, who was friends with him, right? He's dead now, sadly, but he's fucking hilarious. And he had this philosophy around girls that was on point. So you got to check him out, right?
I'm trying to like make it so women just like understand a little bit of like just to sympathize. It's like we're like sport fishermen. This is what I'm saying. Men like to fish. And sport fishing is different from catching fish for food. You just get it, you get it, you catch it, and you know, you show your friends. Because you want them to know that you can catch fish. You take a couple of pictures so you can show people the fish that you have the ability to catch. And then you release it back into the water. But a lot of women in here, you have boyfriends or husbands, you a fish that jump back on the boat and just was like flapping, looking at me like, hi, I was wondering if you're gonna be fishing here again next week, like. Yeah, for other fish, get off my boat. Is that how you treat all the fish? You'd be like, oh, god damn.
And I before I even knew about him, I was doing this stuff, and then I heard from him, and I was like, oh shit, yeah, I do something similar. Not as hilarious as him, definitely not as hilarious as him, but yeah, our styles are kind of similar in that we like to say bold things, right? And this gets me to the tongue in cheek, right? So you can go up to a girl and just be like, like, you despicable son of a gun, or something like that, right? Like, and that's not even that bold, right? There's way, like, he would say stuff, he's just like, you look like fucking breath sticks. Just like, I can smell the sweat from underneath your titties from here, right? And they'd be like, what? And he's like, oh, I'm just playing, like, what's your name, right? So it's like, you say this big thing, and that charges the situation with emotion, and then you just, like, just get rid of that, right? And now it's gone, and it's like, so we're up here with the emotion, or she's up here with the emotion, and now you take away the nasty side of it, and you're just left with this emotion, right? And now you can kind of sculpt that how you will.
Good morning, guys. Good morning, Patrice. I'm really sorry I already did it before, and my boyfriend said if I did it again, he would not
your who friend?
Be very happy.
Your boyfriend, who, your boyfriend that,
friend?
That can't control you coming down here with that energy? It's like telling a tsunami to not get somebody wet.
See, I knew that
your boyfriend going, don't do that, man. See, you don't. It's unattractive. It's unattractive, and you have no use for it. There's grown men here giving you grown men like, oh my god. How old is he? 21, like you or something?
He's 23.
He's 23. He's a young guy. He has young guy jealousy. I have old man. I don't want to touch you.
Balls.
I just want to go somewhere and dream about you. He doesn't dream about you because you're his girlfriend. You're his girlfriend he's supposed to be with. He's some good looking kid, right?
Yeah.
He doesn't understand the evil of a fat middle-aged man who's looking at a little dream, a doll. He doesn't appreciate your breasts. You probably sit down to pee in front of him, right?
This guy's really good, by the way, but I'm still not going to do it.
So, and the point that I, so what I'm saying, he would just say something really harsh like that and then just diffuse it by, ah, I'm just playing, whatever. My thing is, like, you're saying it tongue-in-cheek, so I'm saying something bold, something, like, risque, or even you could say it's rude under, like, some circumstances. But I'm saying it tongue-in-cheek, right? Tongue-in-cheek, not literally tongue-in-cheek, but, like, I'm saying it with a half smile. I'm joking. She knows that I'm joking. I make it obvious that I'm joking, right? And, like, just so as a guide on this, right, every girl is going to be different. Some girls are prissy and aren't up for taking a joke. Some girls have great sense of humor and will cuss you better than you can cuss them, diss you better than you can diss them. And they can take a lot of banter, right? And so there's that scale, but you don't really know. I mean, you can kind of gauge that after a couple of minutes of interacting with a girl. You can kind of gauge where she's on that scale as well. And another way of looking at it is, kind of the hotter the girl, the more you can get away with saying bold things, right? Because she's just, let's say you were on an island with only, it's crass as you to school girls by number, but we all know what we're doing when we do that. So it's, let's say you're on an island with only fives and sixes, right? You wouldn't chat them up by being all like super cocky and saying the bold, harsh thing. You would just like chill, chat them up, because their confidence isn't at a level where they can take like a battering, a verbal battering. But the real like nines and tens, like they honestly can. Their ego, it gives them enough of a shield where they can take this. Some can't, but most can, right? So that's two little models for you there, right? So you're saying things tongue in cheek. You're saying this thing with half cocky smile on your face, and you know what? They fucking love it. that's basically it. The other thing, so self-deprecation, we said at the start of the video about self-deprecating, and that can be bad, right? You don't want to have that sort of nerdy type of humor where it's like, I said the joke, like really hipsterish, like kind of like, I said the joke, like, and it's like, I'm the joke, like, fuck that, basically. What I'm saying when I say self-deprecating is, if you're saying these like bold things, and you're getting a rise out of a girl and you're taking the piss out of her, you can then be self-deprecating as well. So when then she takes a piss out of you, you can roll with it. So let's say I'm chatting to this girl and she's 22 and I'm like, 22, what the hell are you even doing in this club? Like 22, you're too young. Like go home, just go suck a dummy, go suck like your mum's tits. Like, what the hell are you even doing here, right? And she'll be like, let's say she rolls with that, and like, that's not a great example. Let's say she rolls with that and she's bantering me back, and she's like, all right, then how old are you? And I'm like, well, I'm in my 30s. And she's like, in your 30s? Fucking hell, Grandad. And I'm like, yeah, I know. Like, my balls droop down to my toes. Like, they're gray as fuck. Like, I'm sorry. Do you know what I mean? I'm taking what she said and adding to it as well. And I'm showing her that, yeah, I can take the piss out of myself as well, right? And it's these two things together are golden. So you're hitting her up, you're spiking her emotions, you're showing her that, like, look, I'm not another little pussy guy who's just gonna be like, hey, either like, hey, beautiful, like, I'm either that kind of pussy, or I'm the kind of pussy that's just like, would never say something sexually spiking to a girl, right? So she knows that I'm the type of guy who can do that, and then she's looking, all right, so he's the guy who can basically get me wet like that. Now is he the guy who is cool and can take the piss out of himself and what I can have a laugh with? And it's like, if you hit that as well, she's like, she's basically sold. She's like, cool, okay. Like, if the, like that, she's just sold, basically, really. I mean, at that point, you just need to lead her around a little bit. Let's go get drinks. All right, now let's cigarette. Now your mates, now let's go see my mates. Take her over here. You're kissing her at some point, and then it's job done, really. I mean, honestly, it's that good. But yeah, all right, let's leave it there. I'll come back to this, obviously. Humor is a massive topic. Didn't go through too many examples now, but we'll go through some fucking more. You know what? For me, I'm bad at fitness. You know I'm trying to get fit, right? I did 5 miles today, yeah? Boom! No one means to have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop chipping. Oh, hi, hello. The community here. It's like, you despicable son of a gun. You do you, player. Do you know what I really like about you? And she goes, what? He goes, nothing.